Hi, welcome here. Let's discover how to make 3D projects with Graphisoft ArchiCAD 17. Leave comments to improve our videos. All you need to know to create 3D objects is the design section in the toolbox. ArchiCAD is focused in architects' projects, so all templates available will help you at creating windows, doors, columns, and even roofs, all put together to build a simple house in a very short time. This is a very simple one, for example. You can download this project in the video description. First of all, let's see how to move through a 3D project. This is quite different than with 2D projects. Let's suppose to have this simple 3D object. There are many ways to get a preview of it. The first way is to use the elevations. These are used to see the 3D project in all its lateral faces. By default, you have four of them: north, south, west, and east. Each one is recognized through a blue straight segment and an arrow symbol indicating the direction each elevation is following to make you see the project. For example, the north elevation is directed towards the 3D object from north to south. If you double click on the north elevation in the navigator panel, you will right see the project from such point of view, and so the others. You can further edit or add elevations to make custom points of view following other directions. To create a new one, simply copy and paste one and then use the tools already met with the 2D objects to set the direction of the blue arrow. The only thing to be aware of is the length of each elevation. If elevations are shorter than the length shown by the 3D project, it may show up incomplete. Just enlarge elevations as you do with a normal 2D object. The second way is to use the stories. A story is simply a fixed height to see your project from up to down. They are well shown in any of the elevation's points of view. You can create new ones and edit their reference height, right-clicking on them from the navigator panel. Actually, the ground floor is the one you use for your 2D projects by default. You must be careful of how to use these. Stories do work as a collection of objects, and so do not show objects according to their height. For example, if an object belongs to the ground floor story, it won't appear on the first floor story, even if the object is enough tall. It will just appear when you show the ground floor story, where it belongs to. To use stories in the correct way, you need to move objects to the right stories using cut and paste commands manually, correcting the placement using the elevation's points of view. The third way is to see the project in a full 3D visualization. On the right of the standard bar, click on 3D window. In this way, you can see your 3D project in full. From the navigator panel, you can choose a generic point of view or a generic axonometry view. Just double click. Moreover, you can use the orbit command, pressing O key with your keyboard. Then simply click and drag on your preview. To exit, use O or Escape key. While in this 3D visualization, You can use the Explore button to check your project even more carefully. In any of the three ways seen, you can use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out, and the pen button to move around. At this point, we can finally start drawing a generic 3D object. It's up to you to choose an elevation, a story, or a 3D window visualization to create it. You may need experience to draw in the best and most precise way, case by case. There are two main tools to create a generic 3D object, the Mesh and the Morph Tool. The Morph Tool is used to create basic 2D surfaces on your 3D project. Don't confuse this one with a standard 2D object. A 2D object is never shown on 3D previews except from the stories ones. The Morph Tool creates filled polygons in a 3D project. They can be simple 2D lines as well, indeed. The Morph Tool teaches you almost everything of 3D creations, which are pretty similar of what's seen for the 2D objects. First you choose the starting point. Then you need to fix the other points. ArchiCAD will indicate you the distance, the angle, and the three axes directions, as seen with the 2D objects. The pointer will turn into a pencil icon, supported by a small dark gray area, indicating the plane where the straight segment is going to lay. If you want to draw a line, click on the last fixed point, where the pencil will turn to black. Otherwise, you can create a surface, closing fully the line. In this case, the pointer will become a sort of black hammer. Help yourself checking the Cartesian axis. If one is highlighted in yellow, it means that you are currently following such direction. You can always undo creations using Escape key. As seen with 2D objects, you can use guidelines using the big red points, the arrow tool to make up selections, and the small white box to set precise values. Remember to hover objects while in arrow mode to see what kind of objects they are and to select the right one more precisely. You do need practice to make correct 3D design. Don't worry if you are in distress the first times. There are indeed important points to interact with objects. The V symbol indicates the vertices, the free side icon a generic edge, and the small vertical bar the medium points of an edge. There are just two things to keep in mind. A sort of rhombus with a cross on it, that means fixing a point on the face of a 3D existing object. And the story names, that may appear if you place an object on the same height of a defined story. Let's see how to edit 3D objects. Firstly, you have to select them, and then click on a point or on an edge, as with the 2D objects. We will see just how to edit morph objects mostly, since this is the tool that can create any 3D object. But mind that there are many other tools available, depending on the kind of object and on the current step. Click on a vertex. Use drag to move 3D objects without changing the shape. Use free rotate or mirror to rotate in 3D. Multiply to make arrays. offset all edges to extend or shrink the object, keeping its shape. Fillet chamfer to make less harsh the vertex selected. Move node to move a point. Tube is very important to extrude surfaces. To apply the changes of your tool, click on the Cartesian origin. Use the pencil button to extend your morph object, adding new 2D surfaces. These will be just lines or surfaces though. If you want to add faces, use tube instead. Now click on a path. Use insert new node to add a new point and curve edge to make a curved path. When your morph becomes in 3D through tube, you can customize it further. If you click on a vertex, you can fillet or chamfer in 3D, which means smoothing entire 3D corners. If you click on an edge, you can fillet or chamfer it as well. If you click on a face, you can go on using tube or using push-pull. Use bulge to put virtual pressure. You have indeed advanced tools too. Let's see just the split one. In 3D objects, you firstly need to fix a point, a direction, and plus an orientation. To delete a 3D object, right-click on it and go to Delete. The editing tools do change depending on the point of view as well. For example, you can use a story 2D view to stretch 3D objects, keeping their height constant. The second way to build projects is to use the Mesh tool. This builds up just 3D objects that can be created one by one upon another, creating a custom 3D shape. You may need to select all of them to edit and move them all together. These are indeed all the bases you need to create your first 3D project. However, ArchiCAD helps you with several templates to create any part of a house. Apart from some tools, all the ones inside the design section are ready-made templates, from the wall to the door or the roof. Use object to place TVs, chairs, tables and even beds. Simply place them in your project and adjust their placement using different points of view, an elevation or a story one. To get a general idea, download the project in the video description. 3D objects and templates as well can be fully customized through the Info tool. Select first the object and go to Settings dialog. To change the color of the edges, go to Floor Plan and Section, Outlines, and change the color under Uncut Line Pen. To change the face's color, go to Model Section and click on the Paint button under Override Surface. In case you use templates, the Settings dialog box can change significantly. For example, if you use the Object tool, you can choose what to draw. If you use the Roof tool, you can decide the aspect of the roof itself. Plus, any template can become a morph object and can be fully customized. Select the object, right-click, and go to Convert Selection to Morph. This is all. I hope this video has been a great help for you. Check our channel to get new design skills.